Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about spondylolysis and spondylolithesis imaging. Spondylolysis is a condition of defects or breaks in pair interarticularis. Repetitive microtrauma is slightly heterogeneous. Spondylolysis plus anterior slippage of vertebra in relation to vertebra below. Most common sign symptom is asymptomatic. 8%, 40% incident in children with low back pain. Other sign symptom, tight hamstring muscle. Whirling gait secondary to tight hamstring muscle. Back spasm or radiating pain. Chronic low back pain in older child and adult. Back pain exacerbated by rigorous activity. Radiculopathy and Gouda-Egin syndrome in lysis with high-grade spondylolithesis. Demographic age 10 to 20 years. 4.4% at age 6 years, 6% in adult. Predominant in male. Epidemiology incident 3 to 10%, increased incidence in competitive athlete, especially male. Imaging, bone CT, linear lucency or defects in fast in interarticularis, incomplete ring signs of axials on axial imaging plus minus instruction. Spondylolithesis and quadrominal narrowing on sagittal deformated image. Secondary finding of sclerosis and or hypertrophy of contralateral pedicle and lamina. Maybe intense and sensitivity to early stress injury. Spec bone scan imaging is helpful for diagnosis. Intent focal uptake in posterior element or unilateral or bilateral. Triangular pattern of uptake on sagittal image, remote or hill may be occult. Spec CT confirm diagnosis with anatomy and physiology. Hemolysis, adjacent spine protocol toward musculoskeletal system by adding steer T2FS, increased conspicuity of marrow and soft tissue damage. This is a lateral radiograph in a 15 years old female basketball player with back pain, so the linear lucency at L3 are interarticularis. There is no anterior subluxation of L3 related to L4 to suggest spondylolithesis. This is a steer MR in the same patient, so erectional low signal intensity pair inter. Articularis defects bilateral at L3 level with adjacent marrow and soft tissue edema. Non-contrastant CT in a 12 years old girl who present with severe left flank pain for renal stone evaluation. So, an incomplete osseous ring with bilateral destructive par interarticularis at L5. This is bone CT reconstruction, so spondylolysis. At L4, there is no spondylolysis. And this is still Amma in a 14 years old with back pain, so the L3 part effect with edema in the marrow or posterior element and adjacent tissue. Stioma can be helpful in detecting marrow edema associated with spondylolysis. This is contrastant CT, so bilateral spondylosis with an incomplete ring at alpha level. Note the coronal orientation of spondylolysis, which is the oblique orientation of the normal facet joint. Treatment mainly conservative first, surgical the conservative treatment fail or subluxation progresses. Thank you.